¿Sorpresa? La que me dieron a mí, que no me avisaron, qué pelos. Nicholas Edward Cave nació el 22 de septiembre de 1957 en Warrack Naveal, Victoria, Australia. Es un músico, escritor y actor conocido por su voz de barítono y su liderazgo en la banda Nick Cave y The Bad Seeds. Su carrera comenzó en la década de 1970 con la banda The Birthday Party, conocida por su sonido post-punk y gótico. En 1983, formó Nick Cave y The Bad Seeds, una banda que ha sido descrita como una de las más originales y celebradas de las eras post-punk y rock alternativo. Cave también ha trabajado en cine, escribiendo guiones y componiendo bandas sonoras, y ha publicado varias novelas. Estilo de música e influencias. El estilo musical de Nick Cave y The Bad Seeds es una mezcla de rock alternativo, rock gótico, rock experimental y post-punk. Sus letras a menudo exploran temas oscuros como la muerte, la religión, el amor y la violencia. Entre sus influencias se encuentran artistas como Leonard Cohen, Tom Waits, PJ Harvey y Robert Johnson. Evento en vivo 2001. En 2001, Nick Cave y The Bad Seeds realizaron una serie de conciertos como parte de su gira No More Shall We Part. Uno de los eventos destacados fue su presentación en la Columbia Halle de Berlín el 10 de mayo de 2001. ¿Un brindis cencerros?
Sat sadly by his side at the window through the glass. She stroked a kitten in her lap and went, watched the world as it fell past. Softly she spoke these words to me with brand new eyes open wide. We pressed our faces to the glass as I sat sadly by her side. She said, father, mother, sister, brother, uncle, aunt, and nephew, niece, soldier, sailor, physician, mechanic, priest, earth and moon and sun and stars and planets and comets with tails blazing, all of them forever falling, falling lovely and amazing. I sat sadly by her side. The kitten she did gently pass over to me, and again we pressed our different faces to the glass. That may be very well, I said, but watch the one falling in the street. We'll see him gesture to his name.
Anymore than he cares for the lack of it.
from her eyes. I could not wipe the smile from my face as I sat sadly by her side. As I
mean, you can believe in God and not have to go to church, you know, which is what I do. I've never found anything. I've tried, actually, to find some sort of systemizing of my beliefs by going to church and looking at different religions, but I never found a place for it, really. And I think because they aren't the kind of concrete things, and my spiritual beliefs seem to be very fluid and change and all the time, really. And so, you know, I have them, and they're very difficult for me to define, and I don't usually try.
Out of nowhere, but he ain't
microscopic cog in his catastrophic plan, designed and directed by his red right hand.
There's not that many themes, actually. I guess musicians just, there's only about three, you know, kind of love, death and God, as far as I'm concerned, and you just kind of dress them up in different ways. What I do like about the song itself is which I think is different from other forms of art, is that a whole lot of things go on at exactly the same time. You've got kind of the music and the words and the way the words are sung and interpreted, the melodies, all of this sort of stuff, and they can kind of, there's all this sort of emotional information that can kind of collide at the one time and say different sorts of things. I don't play my records, I don't ever willingly listen to my music, you know, I don't kind of put on CDs or kind of, I'm not prone to reminiscing and, you know, reflecting. I don't do that a lot. I just feel I kind of move forward. And Penguin sent me this book, sent me The Galleys, and wanted me to read my lyrics from the beginning to now, and see if they were correct. And it was quite a terrifying thing to do, and took quite a long time for me to recover from, really. Some I really liked, so I was very surprised by some of the early lyrics, some of the birthday party lyrics, which in my mind I'd kind of dismissed as sort of juvenilia or something like that. I thought were really good. They were really kind of ambitious and strange, and other periods that you could, I mean, I could really tell what was going on at the time when I was writing them. It was quite interesting. First day of May I took to the road, stared out the window most of the morning. I watched the rain claw at the glass, and a vicious wind blew hard and fast. Should have taken it as a warning, as a warning, as a warning, as a warning. I'd given my nurse the weekend off. My meals were ill-prepared. My typewriter turned to mute as a tomb, and my piano crouched in the corner of my room with all its teeth bare. All its teeth bare. All its teeth bare. All its teeth bare. Without my coat,
something my nurse would not have allowed. I took the small roads out of town, and I passed a cow, and the cow was brown, and my pajamas clung to me like a shroud, like a shroud, like a shroud, like a shroud. There rose before me a little house with all hope and dreams kept within. A woman's voice close to my ear, I said, oh, why don't you come in here? You're like a soap to the skin, soap to the skin. You're like soap to the skin, soap to the skin. Extended a hearty salutation, but I knew if my nurse had been here, she would have never in a thousand years permit me to accept that invitation. That invitation, that invitation, that invitation. Now you might think it wise to risk it all, throw caution to the reckless wind. But with her hot cocoa and her medication, my nurse had been my one salvation. So I turned back home, I turned back home, I turned back home, singing a song. To catch them in,
hallelujah.
20 pretty girls to carry them down,
hallelujah.
20 deep holes to bury them in.
Bad Seeds didn't record a record for about 4 years, and in that time I kind of put together a little band where I went on tour and I played the piano and sang, and Warren played violin and a couple of other musicians. So it was very low-key, very kind of intimate. And And I was kind of, you know, I was part of the music. You know, I wasn't just singing like a singer, singing over the top of the music. And I guess I learned quite a lot from that. I learned how to sing and play the piano at the same time, which is quite a feat for me to do. And I think learned a lot more about music. And I think that this new record, No More Shall We Part, is, you can hear that going on. I do wish to carry on making music. You know, it's really important to me, and it becomes more and more important. And I spend more and more time at it. And the whole creative process seems to become more affecting to me. You know, so I don't see any reason why I can't. For all my 30s, I always thought this was the last record or the last song and the last day, really. And I'm over 40, and something happens then where you just suddenly realise that it can all just kind of, life just kind of continues, and your creative potential is always there if you kind of treat it with a bit of respect.
Song.
And I don't really know a show that we haven't played the Mercy Seat at. But the thing about the Mercy Seat is, and I think that this is testament really to it being a good song, as opposed to perhaps some other songs that I've written, which I don't think are good songs, is that it has kind of staying power, and it doesn't really matter how you play it. You can play it slow, you can play it stripped right back and sing it alone at the piano, to really kind of heavy versions of it. It always just seems to work in some kind of way. And so we've done a billion different versions of it. It still sort of remains alive to me, really.
I began to warm and chill to objects and their fields. Ragged cup and a twisted mop, face of Jesus in my soup. Those sinister dinner deals, meal trolley's wicked wheels. A hooked bone rising from my food, all things good or ungood. And the mercy seat is awaiting, and I think my head is a burning. In a way I'm yearning to be done with all this weighing up of truth. An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth, and anyway they had no proof, and I'm not afraid to die. Interpret silent catalogue, a blackened two-faced scarlet fog. The walls are bad black bottom kind, they are the sick breath of my hind. They are the sick breath of my hind. They are the sick breath of my hind. They are the sick breath gathering at my hind. Well, I hear stories from the chamber, how Christ was born into a manger, like some wretched stranger died upon the cross. And might I say it seems so fitting, and as we was a carpenter by trade, or at least that's what I'm told. My killing to tell evil across his brother's fist. That filthy fire did nothing to challenge or resist. In heaven his throne is made of gold, and the ark of his testament is stone.